Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today I would like to present about Nestle Malaysia Berhad, Syed Darbi Berhad and Kawan Food Berhad. My name is Sarifah Mukminah binti Muhammad Fauzi and my group members are Nur Ashfarina binti Ahmad Bukhari, Nur Sal Sabila binti Muhammad Rusti, Nur Ain binti Abdul Razak, Nurul Syuhaida binti Darus and Nur Ain Fatiah binti Aziz. First, we talk about Syed Darbi. Represent three entities. First, Syed Darbi Property Berhad, Syed Darbi Plantation Berhad, and third, Syed Darbi Berhad. Started out as a rubber plantation company. From financial analysis, Syed Darbi Berhad from 2015 to 2018, we can see the differences of ratios, but we only talk about profit margin, which is declined drastically from year 2015 to 2017 and starting to rise slightly in year 2018. The firm is able to cover the operating cost by the sale of inventory since the firm has higher than one of gross profit margin. Next, Kawan Food Berhad. This company is in sector of consumer products and services. Kawan Food Berhad is one of Malaysia's leading exporter and largest manufacturer of frozen ASEAN food delicacies worldwide. Financial analysis ratios. Liquidity ratio from year 2015 to 2017 is decreasing. In 2018, the liquidity ratio is increases by 0.27. The decreasing show that the firm may have difficulties to pay its liability on time. Under efficiency ratio indicates that for every 1 ringgit of asset that has been made available to the firm or the firm invest in, the management of KFB is able to generate a return after tax of 35 cents within year 2015 until 2018. Lastly, profitability ratio for 1 ringgit of revenue for year 2015 until 2018 show that KFB earns a net profit before tax of 79 cents for every 1 ringgit of revenue earned by the KFB. It cost of sale amount lump sum to 1 ringgit and 76 from year 2015 to 2018. Therefore, the larger the gross profit margin, the better it will be for the firm. Next is Nestle Malaysia Berhad. First operation at Penang as the Anglo-Swiss Condensed Milk Company in 1912. Financial analysis ratios for Nestle. From financial analysis ratios, we can see that net profit margin for Nestle from 2015 to 2018 are consistently increased, which is from 0.1504, 0.1514, 0.1544 to 0.1587. Net profit margin is to measure the profit for every ringgit of sales that can be used to pay for the sales and administrative expenses. So, in our opinion, Nestle Malaysia Berhad has the highest net profit margin in 2018 and has a consistent increase from 2015 to 2018 of 0.1587. A higher net profit margin means that a company is more efficient at converting sales into actual profit. An increase in profit margin compared to the previous periods margin signals an improvement in both operational efficiency and profitability. A margin higher than those of other companies or higher than the industry average means Nestle Malaysia Berhad perform better than those companies during that period. That's all from me and my group. Thank you.